She says, if I wanted to feel sorry for myself, I'd have stayed with your father.
Oh, that is quite a drop. Let me help you down.
I've got this.
What? Oh, please.
Three times I saved your life. The sinkhole, your foot. What? You'd be dead if my mom hadn't taught me to dress a wound. Fine. Two times then. The sinkhole and just now.
Hey, let me see that.
Leave it. It's nothing. Hey, I'm fine.
Come on, roll up your sleeve and just admit we're friends already.
This is not an admission.
Hey, let me see. It's getting worse.
Listen, it ain't broken or bleeding. It'll calm down. It always does. Let's go. The kid said the ward was this way. You ever hear about the North Pole?
Huh. That old fairy tale?
Yeah. Like this war. Old white guy founds it. Food and fresh water, everyone gets along. That sounds like the fairy tale to me. It's probably just a couple old timers holed up underground. I just hope they got a few supplies for trade. Otherwise, we won't last much longer out here. You think people actually live like this?
Not sure.
I don't know what's in that Fulton's original blend, but I never seen nobody that happy before. Not in real life.
Yeah.
Locked. Great. We can't turn back now. Ain't got nowhere to go. There's gotta be another way through. It's about time. What took you? Hey, look at this. What happened to these poor bastards? Can't let it go to waste. Use it on that bum ankle of yours. Hey, come on. Let's get some distance between us and these bodies. Over here. Oh, this is bad. This is bad with a side of broccoli.
A side of what?
Nothing. Something my ma used to say. Hey, that don't count, by the way. Starting to think looking for this ward wasn't such a good idea. Guess the Deadwood ain't all gone after all.
No.
Ain't no way the war's real. Not with a nest like this out here. You know, maybe best we head back. We retrace our steps. We can find another way out.
Okay, you're safe. Whoa, hold up. We're friends. We're here to help.
Can't hold this forever, Beau!
Thanks. Who are you?
Questions later. We gotta get moving. On three.
We still got each other.
Right. Follow us, you two. That won't be the last of them. What I felt back at the ward.
Wait! You're from the ward?
Shit!
Maybe Santa's real too.
Yeah, it's not far from here. But the way down collapsed behind us. We're gonna have to find another way out.
Would know they've lost.
but they won't lay down without a fight.
Shooting, Traveler.
Yeah, I had some practice.
I'll bet. But don't worry. The ward's as safe a place as any. Safer.
So, it's really real. Food, and water, and folks living with some old white guy?
More or less.
Whoa, let me get you some water.
Yes!
Ooh, that looks like root rot. I've never seen a case this bad.
I'm fine. I don't know why everyone...
We need to get her to the ward, and quick. Doctor, there's her only chance. We'd better get moving, or we lose the light.
Yeah.
This is Wriggler.
Call me Riggs. I got you, darling. Don't worry, friend. We'll take good care of her. Welcome to Ward 13.
Hey, don't worry. Riggs is right. She'll be fine.
Are you okay?
Just a headache.
Hey, Clementine. Let me get you some water.
I'm fine.
Oh, you're not fine. You need rest.
Bo! He's the ward's mayor. Thinks that puts him in charge of everything and everyone. Listen, I'm gonna check in with Ford, and then I'll get some rest. Okay? I've been through a lot worse, you know.
So, Traveler, your friend will be fine. I'm Bo Ward, and this is Ward 13. He must have come a long way. I mean, the root's dwindling and all, but The road's still a dangerous place. What were you two doing out there? For the ward? Really? Huh. I didn't know anybody knew what we were doing here. We've just, we've been cut off from the world for so long that... Well, I'm surprised people know about us outside the gate. Feels kind of nice, actually. Hey, ask around if you need something. Oh, start with Ford. I'm sure he'd like to meet you.
That Donald. Always talking about getting out of here, sailing the sea.
I see you, Traveler. You're the one Ford's been waiting for, though he doesn't know he's been waiting. He thinks he needs help. It's her who needs it. You know, and you don't. Sorry, I shouldn't say. Things get messier when I tell them. I'm Wallace. Did I say that yet? Probably. The site, you know? You have a path to walk. You choose the... That makes a lot of sense now. You're right, of course. Your path is waiting. Tell Brabus and McCabe I sent you. They have what you need. They're the next step on your journey. Goodbye, Traveler.
Travis gotta polish his stuff more.
Well, ain't you a right mutter? Traipsing in that boy what talks to the root? I don't trust Wally with a hot meal. But I also ain't dumb enough to cross him. I don't reckon he was any more specific.
Well, need something with a longer barrel.
Right. Well, the boy's crazy, but he ain't stupid. I can see your gear is, lacking, to say the least. If he asks, You tell him I gave you this. No charge. Riggs is gonna talk my ear off if I don't send you over to him next, isn't he? Fine. Go see Riggs, then. Tell him he can do whatever the hell he wants.
This is not up for discussion, Clementine. You're staying, and that's fine.
I don't remember asking for your permission.
Watch your tone, young lady.
Excuse me? I'm 132 years old, in case you forgot. And I am not
friend.
A child.
Glad to see
you
you're
have
all right.
Over me.
Well, that's right. I do.
But everybody goes
this town needs you. You can't go wandering off after something that
out there.
That might not even exist.
Armor and weapons upgrades.
Oh, that's rich.
Speaking of which, Bo
what
mentioned
what have you been doing the last 100 years, then, huh?
Feedback on
what the hell are you doing right now?
Whatever you need.
Well,
don't be afraid. We
that's
all
different.
Help each other.
I'm trying to fix things.
Things that
I don't suppose
when you tried
he was
to play
more
God.
Particular.
That was Harsgard. I was just
yeah,
following
right.
orders.
Come
I didn't
to me.
Oh, and that makes it okay? You know how many people died because you just followed orders?
Of course I know. You think I don't remember that every goddamn day? I'm trying to make things right here.
So am I. You're such a damned hypocrite, Ford. If
you
I
know
leave,
where to
it's my
me.
Fault. But you didn't break the world. You didn't run after a pipe dream. You didn't abandon your family a dozen times over.
Look, I've made a lot of mistakes. I admit that. But it's because, we'll talk about this later.
Out of my way.
Whoa, what have we here? Ah, the Traveler, of course. Wallace said yes, right on time. Sorry you had to see that. But then again, you've been around. I'm sure you know. Families fight. Andrew Ford. Good to make your acquaintance. I guess my reputation precedes me. Oh, I'm as real as a toothache. I'm sure you've got a lot of questions, and I've got a favor to ask. So let's get to it. You first. Not you precisely, as in... Aren't you clever? Skeptic. That's fine. It so happens I knew you'd be coming today. Or I hoped. Our young Wallace told me. Wallace? He's a special kid. A lot like somebody I used to know. She had bad dreams, too. Dreams about things that hadn't yet come to pass. If you can find me someone who can explain it better, bring him in. Here now, Traveler. You look like someone preparing for a journey. I won't lie. That's exactly the kind of scrapper I need. I've got some business to take care of down in the old ward. And I was hoping you'd be up for helping me. Talk to McCabe first, though. She can give your weapons a bit more punch. Then meet me down by the ward gate and we'll talk more.
You're serious, aren't you? All right, so what the hell is this jerk? I swear, if that boy weren't so goddamn right all the time, he and I'd be having words. Percussive ones. Fine. Well, the only reason anyone bothers me is because I'm good with a hammer. So either I can modify your weapons, or we can find a more creative use for it. Tell you what, I heard you picked up something strange on your little jaunt earlier. Maybe I could do something with it.
lot of help with whatever journey he saw you on. Just tell Wally to be more specific next time, yeah? So we're done here, right? Or do I need the hammer again? The best news I've heard all day. Look, it's not personal. I just don't like being distracted. I get into a zone, you know? Pisses me off when people come by and interrupt my me time. But I'll tell you what. You're clearly not the average stray that shows up here. So I'll make you a deal. You find anything interesting out there, bring it back to me and I'll see if I can use it to mod your weapons. Okay? Oh, and if you tell anyone I was nice to you, I will cut you.
Like you could help an old man take on the world. You ready to do this? Glad to hear it. Follow me. Crank the handle to make it work. This used to be a research facility, cutting edge. We did things down here nobody dreamed of. Not before nor since. Yet, for all our manpower, we didn't know what the stones really were. Until it was too late.
The stones?
The world stones. Giant red crystals that let us see into other worlds, even travel to them. So, what? We just hide the stones away and hope the Soviets haven't found their own. No, we had to know everything there was to know about them. It was a matter of national security, of pride. So, yeah, we opened the door and walked through.
Something was waiting on the other side.
It didn't happen right away. Hell, the inhabitants of the worlds we traveled to couldn't follow us. We thought we were safe. But yeah, the route found a way. After that, well... We all know what happened after that. Locked, huh? Well, this is my house. Come on. I gave Ellen a few things to hang on to, in case of emergency. She must have hidden it around here somewhere. Come on, Ellie, where'd you hide it? That red thing. We call it a dragon heart. Don't ask why. Take it with you. You might need it. Come on, let's go. There you are. Hurry up. Hey, take a look at that matchbook you found. I got a hunch. Let's get this door unlocked. Can't stand around all day.
Is that the...
The World Stone. Yes. Or part of it, anyway. Every shard's as useful as the whole. We shut it down after Harsgard died. Like I told Ellen at the time, the damn thing's more dangerous than useful. Of course not. Never mind. Now, let's see if that worked.
Work to do what, exactly?
To bury this place. Not just lock it away, but get some explosives and bury it in a tomb of concrete. More dangerous than useful, traveler. Remember that.
Ford?
Ford! Ford!
Oh, man. Bo is gonna be pissed.
Surely we'll get up.
Clementine? Hey.
Did he tell you how to use it? Do I even want to?
System failure is imminent. The core has been compromised. The utility is required. Commencing acquisition.
Ah! Help!
Clementine!
Don't let go! Stop slipping! Take
me! Let it go! Clementine! Shit!
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Don't do it. Don't you do it! Oh, this is so stupid. Guys. This is all insane. Both the crystal and Ford. I better get moving if I'm gonna find Clementine.
Paxeltak. Those foreign to the pound have not been seen upon Yesha for long, long. The pestilence takes me. The Paxeltak. How comes it here, to Yesha? The Red Crystal. I have seen them in my restless slumber. The pestilence think of them often. Especially the stones of the Paxeltak's earth. I am Bedell of the Vaunt. When this world was young, the Pan did service to the green and growing things. Now, the pan betrays the world. And the world, the wolf, betrays the pan. Farewell, Bazeltech. May the Red Doe watch its steps.
Okay, this is it. Thank you. Over. Here we go. I've never seen anything like this before.
All right.
Here we go.
This isn't looking good. Come on.